Hi everyone, welcome back to the Axure RP repeater series. In this video, we'll explore ways to manipulate text data stored in a repeater's dataset. You'll learn how to format text displayed on widgets in the item, how to combine dataset text with static text, and how to perform functions on text before it's displayed. As we've covered before, alpha and numeric data is stored in a repeater's dataset as plain text. If you want to display the data with formatting, such as bold, italic, or underlined, the easiest way is to format the widget that displays the data. Sometimes, though, you may want to have mixed formatting on a widget. In this case, change the set text action in the repeater's item loaded interaction to use the rich text option. Notice here that I've combined the dataset column expression with some static text. Anything you place outside the double square brackets will be displayed as is in every repetition of the repeater item. You can include as much static text as you like, and you can place your bracketed dataset expression anywhere within the static text. You can also include multiple bracketed expressions in a single set text action. This is helpful when you want to display data from multiple columns on a single widget. So far, we've only worked with text data exactly as it appears in the repeater dataset. But what if you want to change that data in some way before displaying it? For example, you may want to convert a bit of text to all caps or multiply a product price by a tax rate. You can do this by including math operations and JavaScript functions inside the double square brackets. Some of the most common math operations include addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and toFixed, which rounds a numeric value to the specified number of decimal places. Some of the most common text functions include toLowercase, which converts the text to all lowercase letters, and toUpperCase, which converts the text to all uppercase letters. There are many more operations and functions you can use with your repeater data. Check out the link in the video description to see them all. That's all for now. In the next video, you'll learn how to dynamically add rows to a repeater's dataset in the web browser. Thanks for watching, and happy prototyping.